and she's right here in the studio. Please welcome Tina Arena.
Hello.
A little alarmed by the warnings of war and bloodbaths.
I was a bit worried. I thought we've had sort of certainly had enough, but it's Tay-Tay war. Bless. What can I say?
8 years.
Yeah.
Did you clock that it was that long?
Like, no. I never think about it. I never think about it because you're always working in some way, shape, or form. So I don't. And when you're reminded that it's 8 years, it's like, what have I been doing?
But it must feel good to have it out at this, you know, stage.
Well, it does feel great. It's out on the 14th of July.
Yeah.
The single is out now, House. It's a very interesting documentation of 2 years of being locked up. Mm. So it's a diary of sorts. So, you know, when people sort of ask you questions about, you know, well, what are the songs about? Well, listen to the record. It'll kind of give you a pretty good idea of what the direction of it is, what the content is.
It's called Love Saves. This is quite an earnest question for me, but what did love save you from?
I think love saves everybody. I'm just not sure whether everybody is aware of that.
Oh.
It saved me from, I don't know, it saved me from horrible thoughts. It saved me because I think that love is probably one of the most vital things that human beings need, next to water and food and whatever. So love did save me. And love, because it does.
I was about to say, love makes the world go round, and this album is actually coinciding with a world tour. Mm. And your fans are diehard. How many have followed you around from the very beginning? Because I'm sure we've got your biggest fan in the studio audience this morning and this afternoon.
Yeah.
Tonight. Had a bit of a moment there.
Yeah, I've been very lucky. I'm really lucky, Sarah. I've been lucky for a long time because they do continue to grow. And they come on my journey and they take what I do and the experiments, the good stuff and the stuff that's not so great, they still take it on board and they support it. And I guess it doesn't help them, but it's a part of everybody's evolution because, you know, songs and music is a soundtrack to our lives, whether we actually write it or whether we just listen to it and experience and feel something from it. So that this record is particularly important to me because it's excruciatingly independent, it's very frank, and everybody knows that I'm frank and
you
not my name.
Bomb.
But I do. Yeah, and I find it quite extraordinary that we live in a world where the one thing that we all are owed as human beings is to be told the truth, yet it's the most difficult thing to ascertain in whatever it is that you do. So for me, my truth and what it is that I live with are people, and I know that sounds horribly indulgent, but it's not, because it's just what I do for a living. But it is my it's a perspective, and it's a very honest perspective. So you will hear all sorts of things. And, you know, the only thing I don't do is name call.
Well, speaking of names...
No, don't go there.
You're going on a tour, right?
Yeah.
And an amazing venue.
Tour.
A world tour.
A world tour.
And often venues get named after people. Are you ever going to a venue and saying this
there's
is...
No, Tina Arena's Arena.
There's not...
Because it doesn't make grammatical sense.
But you could just call it the Tina Arena.
No, because it doesn't sound...
Tina's Arena.
...good enough. No, that sounds sexual. And that's not... No. That's 1 minute. We've got 1 minute to go. How do I get a minute and Taylor Swift get 15? How does that work?
What venue would you... Like the Thunderdome? Tina's Thunderdome. Like,
Tina's
what
Thunderdome.
Would you be... The Thunderdome, Hamish, would be the least of the venues that I would name, with all due respect to the Motorheads.
Now, you appeared on the French version of The Masked Singer.
Yes, I did.
You can't give it away, obviously. How was the experience? Could we ever see you pop a mask off down here, perhaps?
No.
No?
No.
Oh, look at
it's
you.
It's hard. Oh. The Masked Singer is hard for anybody because you are totally isolated from everybody. You're in a dressing room, I was in France. So, of course, the French were on sort of saving, you know, economy saving heating, saving on this, saving on that. I had little heaters in my room. I was so cold. The apartment was cold. Yeah, you're warm in the costume, but what I'm saying is you're ostracised from everybody. Wow. So you literally live in a bubble, and I don't, you know, I'm not a girl in a bubble. So, look, it was good. I had a good giggle. I loved the costume. I got an opportunity to sing some great songs, singing Spanish, French and English. So I had a good time.
We're getting the hard wind up.
We're getting
Tina's
the wind
new
up.
Album, Last Saves, is out July 14. Tickets to see Tina live are available now. Please thank Tina Arena.
Thank you.